through 9 inches of rope in the air, 3-foot sections, and cut it in half in one swipe. That's pretty impressive. Then afterwards, you have to chop through this. There's no speed trial or anything. You just have to go through it. The edge is not allowed to curl or nick or dull very much. It still has to shave your arm afterwards. And then it gets put into this vise here where it has to be able to bend 90 degrees without breaking.
But can you have cracking in the edge?
No.
You can have cracking one cut
from the edge. Yes. But it's rare these days that it cracks. In the 80s, it used to be common that the edge would crack, but nowadays it's extremely rare that there's any cracks. And often it comes back to almost straight, which I find is just incredible, the possibilities of what these knives can do.
Are you allowed a backup knife or?
No, you have, it's a one shot deal, one knife. If I wanted to be really nasty to him, I could have say, I don't believe you forged this. Bring a forge and show me how you forge a knife and how you do the heat treating for it. Or show me a video how you did that. Some of the guys used to do that to people just to be annoying, but we're not going to get into it.
The worst happens if he feels this thing. You can't do it again for
6 months.
For 6 months. So then he'd have to get a hold of me and see about arranging another one for 6 months from now.
Can any Master Smith do the test?
The Master Smith test is exactly the same test, but it has to be a Damascus knife that he made.
No, he's asking,
I'm asking
can have the examiner.
The examiner.
Can be
any
Master Smith.
Okay, can do the.
Yeah, I'm the guy who's here right now. I'm one of three in Canada.
Okay.
Right now.
There's only three Master Smiths in Canada?
Yeah. There used to be four, but Jackie Hayes retired and is completely out of knife making. There's Mickey.
Mick Langley. Wally Hayes and you.
Wally Hayes, me. I'm the last one.